everybody, and welcome back to the Western Wilds. It is July, and we are in the midst of an oat harvest. We have got our Thorgrim coming along, and we have made some grass fields since we were last together. So while we don't stream typically on Wednesdays, at least not as of late, had a little change of plans earlier today. So that means we're live. See what we can get done here on the Western Wilds. Waylon, Goldeneye, Derek, Bergness, welcome, welcome, welcome. Quinnigan Farms, what is up? Well, that's a cage I haven't seen before. The one down there with the needle. Right there at the top of the green, I guess maybe that's RPM, or maybe that has something to do with flow rate of the grain. I don't know. All you did was mow the grass. Well, we have a big old grass field now. Look at this. Look at this grass field. That is all grass, and this is grass. We went to town. Now the PF score on all of these is abysmal, even though everything is perfect. But look at that, 99 and 93. Alphatron, good evening to you, sir. Sure to post in the poll. Looks like the vast majority of you are excited to see what might come of the Volvo Farm Sim 22 partnership. Oh, now we are way past the green on this side. I don't know what that means. Yeah, we think of Nikendo. Japanese sword. Japanese fencing, basically. But Eric, I think it is Volvo Construction only. If you notice the blog post, it seems to be Volvo CE, which is Volvo Construction Equipment. I don't think it's Volvo as a whole. I don't think we're going to see machinery that isn't part of the construction equipment line. The That's why I think, you know, a lot of the time we talk about wanting to see more John Deere, American John Deere stuff. Well, from my understanding, the agreement is with John Deere Europe, the European branch of John Deere. So naturally they have a licensing agreement with European John Deere stuff. Not all of John Deere, because John Deere Europe is one entity. John Deere America, as I understand, is another entity. No, no, no Highlander skills here. Just being trained to whack people in the head, take hands off, and jab you in the throat with a sword. So nothing, you know, overly chivalrous. But he's always been into wanting to, you know, pretend that he's sword fighting and stuff. So we saw the class and it was fairly affordable. People thought we'd enroll him. He mostly likes it. I mean, being eight, right? There's days where he's less wanting to go. And then there's other days that he has an absolute blast, right? Schultz, what is up? Raznek is in the house. What's Volvo BM? I don't know what BM stands for. Rabbit Rob! Oh, so it'd be like Volvo Agriculture. Ravenloft, welcome. But yes, we had a big storm moving through here. And the side of town where the park is, which is where his Wednesday night class is located, there's lots of downed trees, there's lots of flooding. We had heavy rain, heavy winds. Apparently we had some hail that I wasn't necessarily aware of. And when I picked him up from the park where his summer camp is, we didn't have any power. I have no idea how long they didn't have power. So it's basically, we're like, yeah, you're not going to class tonight because we don't know if the park is going to get power back. We don't know if they're going to get more rain, how bad the flooding is going to get through the park. And, yeah. Well, Ravenloft, it's all up to you. You want borders around the fields and put them in. Right? That's the whole idea behind maps like Western Wilds. Make the fields the shape you want, the size you want. If you want hedges around the fields, well, you can use the build mode and draw hedges, right? You could always go into here, into decoration. And draw hedges around the fields. Look at that. Hey everybody, and welcome back to the Western Wilds. We are here for a rare Wednesday night live stream. Had a little change of plans for what we are usually preoccupied with on a Wednesday. So I thought, what the hey, let's fire up the old Western Wilds and see if we can't pass a few hours. This video is brought to you by Farmalls Forever and Lawrence Anderson. Thank you for being farm barons. I think my brain is still on holiday. Today was the first day back after a four-day weekend. Thankfully, I wasn't back in the office. I was remote today. Tomorrow will be the first day back in office since last Friday. Oh, that sounds awesome, Derek. Sounds awesome. Yeah, as I was saying before, the credits Ravenloft on this type of map, No Man's Land, or any of those other kind of build your own maps. If you want hedges between the fields, you can put those in. If you want fences around the fields, you can put those in. If you want trees around your fields, well, you can put those in also. Skitters, workbench. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We are harvesting oats. But we have, since we're last together, I have put in a massive real field of grass here. So all of this is now grass. As you can see, this is also grass up here. So this is now legit grass that we can now fertilize, lime. And we'll see. We'll see what we get as far as yield goes. Well, we've got PF score 99 now, 94. These are awful low. I'm sure they'll pop up hopefully after we maybe do the first lawn mowing job on those. I saw something rash show up in my recommended. Didn't have a thumbnail, but showed up in my recommended. It is legit grass. It's not, you know, illegitimate grass. No straw swath. No straw swath. I don't have anything to do with straw other than to sell it. So I thought, what the hey, let's just not worry about it. Dr. Drula, thumbs up to you too. You're welcome. I think my core temperature works running awful cool. Now tomorrow night we'll still be on Forza Horizon 5. Let's see what we're doing on Friday. My graphics card shipped. My power supply shipped. But I don't know where they are in the whole process. I guess I'll find that out in the morning, hopefully, when tracking information updates to see if I will maybe be streaming or not on a new card. Schultz, what expansion are we talking about? Are we talking about Phase 4? Phase 3? Oh, 4 is July 19th, I think. So, two Tuesdays from now. Perfection. Ah, we have a full trailer. Shut the rattle can off. Jump in the next rattle can. See if we can line ourselves up on the auger again. Already got the auger set up. Mirror is completely useless. I feel awful close in rear. Yeah, like I said, I feel awful close. Woohoo! I was looking at it the other day, right? We got this engine here that's supposed to run and power the auger. So there we have hydraulic hoses, okay. Alright, so there's the hydraulic. I guess that's the belt that runs, that's the motor that runs the lower belt. I guess those are the hydraulics. That bill. Why did I stop? Yeah, somebody converted it. Giant created one. Right there. It's not the not the two-parter, but it's a backhoe, or the AGI pack, as well as all types of other augers and a few bins. Need help unloading. See? We got this. We got this. I'll be streaming tomorrow. I'll be streaming Forza Horizon 5 at this time tomorrow. We'll be checking out the, what are we in? Winter? Season 9 winter? Or are you talking to Sir Raznak there? I would vote for the holler myself. Yeah, well, that's the way you, I mean, it's the way you should start a good lawnmower, too, right? You slowly engage that mower deck when you got the engine running idle. Okay? You get slowly get that mower deck engaged once you get it locked in. Then you rev up on the throttle and drop the deck and off you go. These old girls, they need to be coaxed into working. Ease her on in to the engage. Oh, she just like to drive it on full throttle, just send it. No. You get her to idle. You slowly ease that lever in. Something's not aligned, right? You know, you don't want to be. Tookie, well spoken. Sounds like someone that would be using someone else's equipment. And Hoonigan Farmer, we thank you very much for that. Well, that does not sound like a very good partner to me. About the same as it had been, except we added a anhydrous tank. Made any changes to the main farm after we built it out. There you can see part of the grass field we made. There's the other part. Well, no, not the first episode. I mean, there you can see it. I think building the farm was probably 4 videos. I think between episode 1 and 2, I changed a decent amount between 1 and 2. Left some key things in key places, but redesigned some other stuff. That's right, we added some legit grass. I don't know about the new honeybee headers, but I would expect, assuming the header doesn't require more horsepower than the harvester can put out. I mean, in general, any header will work with any harvester, assuming the horsepower will work. GoldenEye, I think he means more illegitimate grass. You know, grass of the illegal variety. I assume these honeybee headers are of Facebook fame. Yeah, I'm 100% sure I haven't logged into Facebook in the last month. I haven't been to Facebook entirely this month. And I feel awesome for it. Derek, that is a great accomplishment. I think that's an absolutely fabulous idea. Can we make it to the end? I don't know. We're getting some outstanding yield here. 6% to the end. Maybe. Now we're in some lower yield over here. So did y'all see the forage harvester that came out today? There was a trailed forage harvester, or basically a three-point attached forage harvester that lets you attach either to the front of the tractor or to the rear of the tractor. And apparently you can attach one to the front and rear to double your working width. Great way to get into chopping with a minimal amount of expense. Some of the farm. We've got a big open cow pasture over there. We've got some dairy cows. We've got another little lot over here with some beef cattle in it. A couple silage bunkers we haven't really made use of. Some fermenters there. We got our bins, our farmhouse, our little garage, some machine sheds, bale storage, our workshop. Liquid storage. And then we've got some greenhouses over there. Oops. In the wrong vehicle. Thought I was in the harvester. The little one, no. The little one is part of the don't know what pack that's in. This little one is part of the Meridian Bin Pack. It was a mod came out, Meridian Bin Pack. Has a whole bunch of different size Meridian bins. That's part of that. I can sell them because I put them all down. I didn't remember. Hello, Mr. Super H. Then we got some sheep hanging out here. They're a big open cow pasture. Once we get some things figured out. I mean, right now it sounds like there's, I don't know, there's a little short on interest. But, I mean, there's what? We got three people that are interested, but don't want to, don't feel that they can, you know, run a place by themselves, so they kind of want to partner up. I think maybe at this point in time, it might be best to just do a full-on... kind of pseudo community deal. I put something in there today about maybe suggesting I just upload my single player live stream multi or save, where we've got the, you've got the pig farm, you've got the sheep farm, the cows and the horses and the fields, and just kind of go at it from there. Bin pack is right here. I mean, we got all a semblance of bins, different sizes, different shapes. From a little one to a big one. Can't wrap small bales. Nope. Can't wrap them. There's been some people interested in making a wrapper to wrap them, but base game, there's no wrapping of them. What's up? It's a very good harvest. Very good yield. Yep, you can pick them up with the pro stack and make a 14 bale stack of them. Move them around and then cut the stack open and then have individual bales again. But the wrapper doesn't recognize them. Baby bales. So it looks like we get about 5 passes before we're full on up. Dwayne, the world's pretty good. The world's pretty good. We had a storm come through earlier. Had the flickers of lights a little bit. Didn't really lose power, but areas around us did. I tell you, it's so funny. Right down the street from us, there's a major four-way intersection in town, and the lights were out. Cops put up, you know, stop sign sandwich boards at all four intersections, right? Basically turned it into a four-way stop until lights will work. I tell you, people are stupid. You know, I never realized that when you come up to a four-way stop, if the car in front of you goes and you're behind that car, that's like a license to go too. So if you have like a line of 6 cars and the lead car goes, apparently all 6 cars in that line get to go. I mean, maybe I've not been in driving school for a long time, but I was pretty sure a four-way stop was like, you know, everybody takes a turn. You go, I go, they go, they go, and then you get to go again. You know? Not, oh, if you're close enough to the guy in front of your bumper, then you just get a pass along too. And it's one of those four-way intersections. It's not just 4 ways straight. It's 4 ways with everybody turning ways too. Right? So it's 4-way with left and right ways at each way. So is that like a 12-way intersection? It was quite interesting. I don't think we're gonna make this one. We're at 92%, we got a long ways to go. Make it. Did not make it. We also have some pallets to sell. I remember I got a tractor set up halfway over to my dairy with some pallets I need to pick up. Here's my legit grass field. Ready to rock and roll. Yeah, don't you know the turning lane is so many, it's for so many purposes. It's also a merging lane, right? And I'm gonna eventually turn, so I'm just gonna get in that lane and drive for a mile. And then heaven forbid someone is in the lane that's actually turning in the opposite direction while you're trying to drive to your turning destination. And then you get all snooty about how they're in your lane. I had some illegal grass fields over there. I legitimized myself as a farmer. We're now legit grass farmers. Let's check the growth. So we're in July 4 sorghum should be ready next month. Then our corn and our beans are going to be ready in October. So September is going to be a mowing month, I think. I think we're going to mow the grass in September. Captain Kiwi, you are very wrong. Giants would not have that, as that would not maintain their kid-friendly rating. So there may be such a mod out there on the third-party sites. But that is definitely not something Giants put out. Oh, Ricochet Rebel, no problem. I mean, it's part of the Kubota pack. So, where is it? We got it. Kubota pack, right? That is by Iconic. He went and rebranded a whole bunch of in-game stuff to be Kubota. Because, quite frankly, I would say most of the stuff that we use comes from a handful of actual factories and gets different paint and logos slapped on it. So he made Kubota mowers. He made Kubota tedders. We've got the Kubota fast bale. And then we have the Kubota spreader that also does lime for the Kubota sprayers. And some Kubota cultivators, power harrows, Kubota plow, and a Kubota seeder. So yeah, we can thank Iconic for doing that. He typically posts his stuff on Facebook. This was his very first Mod Hub mod, I think. Hopefully he will be incentivized to submit a bunch of other stuff to Giants. I haven't really kept track of him. I really don't keep track of modders in general. But I know he released a bunch of stuff in 19 that was, you know, paintable. A lot of base game stuff that you could repaint, reskin. Later, Raz. Catch you on the later side. Where's the truck? Oh, it's okay. The holdup was licensing, right? Several podcasts ago, Giants did a segment during their Buy Friday podcast about what it takes to bring a licensed brand into game. And they interviewed one of the guys that does a lot of the back-end licensing work. And he had commented that in his time at Giants, he has seen it take up to 4 years. 4 years to bring a brand into the game. So imagine. Imagine if it took 4 years to bring Kubota in. That means they were working on it in 2018. Right after Farm Sim 17 was released, they started working on Kubota. Let's pretend. Then Farm Sim 19 comes out. They're still working on Kubota the entire life of 19. And then we finally get Kubota in 22. That is kind of the concept here, right? So when you see Giants make an announcement about having a new partner in Volvo, don't expect to see Volvo in phase three of year one season pass. Unless they've been holding this Volvo licensing card for a long time already. Don't expect to see it in phase four of year one. Because again, unless they've already been holding this licensing card and they just now decided to make the announcement, right? It would be a miracle if you saw something in year two for Volvo. And shift P brings you into build mode, right? And what, Alt P brings you into wardrobe. Let's change our look. Man, it's July. We need to be cool. And now we are Mr. Cool. Alright, once we're done harvesting, we'll go play with pallets. Probably feed our animals. And then make it August. Yeah, the wardrobe is definitely, you know, your player selection screen is definitely more diverse in 22. I really wish that the clothing was a bit more moddable, right? Imagine if we could have basically add-in clothing. No one's unlocked that little secret. Yeah, we used to be able to change our color of plaid. And maybe our hair color. Can we get through here? No. It is the Case Axle Flow 2188 of the Case IH Axle Flow 2100 series, available on the Giants Mod Hub. That's why we have energy drinks. Oh, Captain Kiwi, I suspect people are working on it. At least to try to mod it in. Jim is in the house. Imagine if we can have modded clothing. Maybe clothing that could come with the map. Right, we could have maybe authentic clothing for a map made by aliens. I wish she'd rattle a little bit more when you turned it off. Sprint! 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 Brock, what's up? If we're going to get that extreme, we need to be able to put some dip in the mouth and then have a button we hit to spit. We gotta have a little cup for when we're in the tractor. And then to make it age appropriate, we would have sunflower seeds. And we'd be spitting sunflower seed husks into the cup. Stephen, what's up? Ta-da! Ta-da! When you got a truck that actually has working mirrors, you can do wonderful things. Shut that rattle can down. Up the fence and suck in the gut. Oh, I'm stuck. I can't apparently suck it in enough. Oh, I got through. You know, when you suck in the gut, you legitimately lose like 20 pounds. It seriously works that way. Alright, now let's set up for the next harvest. Oh, let's go over here. Got this to be set up, I forgot all about it. Oh, you want hand tools? You need to go work on Hoff Bergman. Right? So we've got 11,000 liters of sunflowers. We need to drop off at the mill. But before the mill destroys our trailer, we need to turn the mill off. Else will totally get clobbered. FS Proctor, welcome. On. Do we have more for the dairy to pop out? Nope. We don't have too terrible much. We might as well go to the train yard. Oh, Derek, you're one of those. Leaving tools where you last used them, hey? You know, at work, when we get those kind of guys, we threaten to buy them a pink satchel with pink tools. That way we know exactly who's left what where. And proper auto load at that, Captain Keeley. Right? Proper auto load where I can have a mixed bag of stuff. No auto fill trailers. All right, Derek. Thanks for dropping by. We'll be on for another hour. Should you free yourself up? Did have the right button. Let's turn it around. Skeeter Electric, more power. Oh, maybe we should use a pellet fork. Stab a couple. We're making sure the eggs are good. Just make sure the eggs are good. Usually, picking up pallets like this is a recipe for disaster. So why not? Good thing we got all those batteries in the back, because those pellets of oil are heavy. This is what you call the diagonal fork. Tell you that such a question is impossible to answer, because what sounds good to me may not sound good to you, right? Oh, power lift. Yeah, baby. Don't do this at home. This is a closed course with a professional driver. Ooh, he's your daddy. I don't care who you are. You gotta be impressed with that. Oh yeah, we also know how to ride on two wheels. Oh, I know, because I don't get smashed into at every turn. That would be playing Forza. Feed our animals, and then we're going to fast forward. We'll need to feed two areas that run out. Mr. Neo, what is up? There we are. Get to it. There you are. All right. It's August. We're sure to have crop to harvest. But they still ran out. How am I supposed to keep these guys healthy if they run out of food every single day? Magic forks. Magic forks. We could all do with a set of magic forks. Our forks. I know, right? Like this. Look, these don't show up until you get lickety close to them. Look, like there. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, there it is. Go a little bit away. Oh, look, it vanishes. But why do I see them all everywhere? Like the water trigger? Oh, there it is. Where is it? There? Not there. There? Not there. But I see them all over there. I mean, I can turn them off. Why don't we just have them not show up when we're 7 miles away from them? Once you know where everything is, you can just turn them off. Right? Boom, now they're all off. But if you don't know where stuff is, did you put a word, two sentences without a period? Oh, yeah. Yeah, the bot is a bit dumb. I need at least a couple more of these. Kendrick, thank you very much for the sub. Yeah, that's what I mean, Mr. Dio. It's a, the bot's stupid. So you typed MIL dot rest of million, billion. So it saw a word, or it saw letters, a dot in letters, and said, oh, that's a link. No, it's not a link. Someone who mistyped. Oh, give it a little goose. What's your question? What's that question, El Compa Gordito? Alright, one more load should do us. Then we gotta get everybody water. think you did. I don't know. I didn't like it for some reason. I forget why. I'm really particular. I think I added it. No. Sure. You can clean up cow manure with good steer. After mowing and before the first growth state, because a grass roller will basically delete growth back to the no growth state. And the grass care roller is different than the regular roller. The grass care roller is a smooth roller, whereas the regular roller is spiked. Greedy Troll, welcome. It was like right here, like legit. Now it's vanished. Are you serious? Oh, there we go. Yeah, for some reason the water's way over here. Alright, there we go. Harvest thy grain. I am doing well. Hope you are doing well, Greedy Troll. So some of you saw the pictures of the homemade boneless wings I made. Made those for the youngest because he's got a taste for wings now. Apparently the buffalo sauce I picked was a little bit too hot. And apparently I put too much on. Because he was hurt. He was a hurtin'. Chris, you're not allowed to use GPS. You've got the little stuff, right? Oh, are we missing a little strip? No, we're good. David, we harvested 2 oat fields. We took some pallets to market. We fed our animals, and now we are harvesting more crop. Leach Lynn Riley, thank you very much. Ah, big iron. Big iron, GPS, all the way. Now don't let that spoil you. All right, can't have that spoil your need for the old stuff. Eric the Crazy Viking is in the house. Welcome. We're going to be full on up when we get to the other end of the field. Big time yield. $94.99 gives us 7%. Yikes. We need to get this up, we need to get this up, we need to get that up. Need to mow the grass. Hopefully all these numbers will climb. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, we got good yield. Good yield. Probably, Mr. Dio, probably. I don't know how you do it. I'd say anything's possible with a script. Well, those numbers took a nosedive. We had really good numbers, then we mowed the grass. And when we did that, their numbers took a nosedive. So we had to put in legit grass fields and hope that that brought our numbers up. Actually, you know what? I put that in the wrong bin. We're gonna have to move that auger. This bin has sorghum in it for our chickens. So we need to move this. A little bit overkill for the bin, but hey, that's what we got. Yes, you can just go in and change the ownership of the farm land, right? But then it's no longer owned by you. It's still there. Yeah, if you had dynamic fuel prices, seed prices, you could try to, you know, figure out when to buy seed. Although realistically, you don't want to stockpile seed, because seed isn't as good, you know, as seed ages, its germination percentage drops. So you don't really want to carry seed from one year over to the next in real life. So you don't want to be shopping for seed when the price is right. You're going to be shopping for seed when it's time to seed. So you have as fresh seed as possible. Fertilizer, you know, if you don't have the proper storage capability, then, you know, might clump up. Might go, I don't want to say inert, but it might not be the best investment if you end up not being able to use it right. Oh, It's probably because you're on PC. Or just that's what I would guess. I don't know. Rabid Rob might be able to comment. I think he plays with a PlayStation controller on PC. If he sees the Xbox, buttons, or if he sees the, or if he sees the PlayStation buttons. Well, what is up? Welcome to a rare Wednesday night live stream. We're going to close out the poll. Let's see how many votes we've got here. 74% of you are saying that you are excited for the Volvo announcement. See what might be coming along. 96 votes. We'll put our pipe out of the crop when we come back down that row. Mike gets Xbox controller buttons. I mean, it might just be a Windows thing, where Windows just assumes if you're using a game controller, you're using an Xbox style controller. So it presents you with the classic Xbox button. Dare say that is probably a more common combination of Xbox controller on PC. What is a Thrustmaster 1600M? Is that a joystick? That is a joystick indeed. I have no experience with a Thrustmaster 1600M. I have no experience with a joystick other than the side panel joystick. Oh, we are full. Chris, typically on a laptop that uses combo buttons like that, there is an FN button that you have to push and hold down when you use the button for the other function. So you should find an FN button, and sometimes that button is blue, and then that would activate the blue function on that particular key if it is a multi-function key. But that may or may not work in game. There you go. Cha-ching. Good morning, sir. Good morning. They may be clunky, but they take AA batteries. So in a pinch, you can just toss a AA battery in them, and they work. PlayStation controllers take what? Proprietary battery? Proprietary charger? Rabbit Rob, I think he was not paying attention for a little while. Just love it when the harvester is able to turn at the end of the lane and just skip a row. No stopping, you know, doing a three-point turn. Talking about. No idea, but maybe. Maybe it's newsworthy. go now, I guess. We're able to do more passes. Still gonna run out of ground. Come back, Captain Kiwi. I don't use a controller at all. I use a mouse with a trackball. I use the side panel. And I use keyboard. I use wheel. I use pedals. I use everything but a controller. I had no idea we were this full. I should have emptied this. No idea. Is a blind deer for sure. Oh, yeah, we made it. Holly Countess, welcome. Welcome to the show. Party show. Oh, if we only had fill planes, right? We only had fill planes that came up. I think we had that in 15 or 13. Silos had fill planes. Just like your truck. Just like your truck and trailers. Oh, it goes good. It goes good. We've got power. I think that's better than some folks around here who lost power when we had a storm come through earlier. It's actually why we are streaming tonight, because what we would normally be doing on Wednesday night is, well, we didn't go because I don't think they had power. Birdie. Mayhem is Sunday nights. Thursday is organized chaos. whole time. And farm sill nights are just chill. So I don't know what to think of this Hot Wheels expansion. If the Hot Wheels section of Forza is anything like the crazy labs that we've seen the last few weeks, I am not sure. Idea of fun is not being afraid of falling off the track to my doom every moment. Although I do need to log in and see. I saw where a guy posted a video about the Toyota that was going to be a winning vehicle, I think, in this coming week's events. But then he was also saying that people were buying it on the auction house. It was listed on the auction house at $6 million, or $16 million. I was like, oh. So I listed mine for $16 million. I'm gonna see if somebody was crazy enough to buy it. Because we're just gonna win it back. I think it was a 10-pointer tomorrow. It's a 10-pointer. You win that Toyota. So I need to boot Forza up after the stream and see. Somebody went and dropped $16 million on it. Or if I still own it. Now we are getting a ton off this deal. Wow. I see where the hired helper messed up. We get a better look at it when we come back across the field. So what mods released today that excite you or spark some interest? And what in the testing thread has you giddier than a little schoolboy? I know some people would be happy if a ethanol plant would ever get released. Yeah, she is decent. I don't know how big it is. It's that big. However big that is. So it's like 1.5 plots wide by a half plot tall. I here you go. Here you can see where the hired help just, yeah, they didn't even stop along map boundaries. I don't know what they stopped for. What are you talking about, the Bergman trailer? You talking about this one, the Brockman? Uh-oh, Schultz has moved on. Crushing many a hopeful player's hearts and minds. Is that something that came out today? I had a feeling this is going to fill me up. I didn't see too much today that really got me going. Take a look once we get our dump going. Oh, okay. I saw that. I didn't know what the heck it was. I could see why you would like that. I can see. Indeed. That is pretty cool. One of the cases where the thumbnail was like, did not sell what it does. I don't know why I even did that. You know, you look at the thumbnail and I'm like, oh, that's like one of those trailed lifters. Honestly, the first thing I thought was, oh, that's one of those fast farming things. That's a cheaty mod. Not interested. But had I known what the heck it was. Alright, Captain Kiwi, catch you later. We're gonna be done here in just a few minutes anyway. I gotta go to work at the office tomorrow morning. So we can't stay up late. Old man needs his sleep. Clean up the AI's mess. Did not make it back. Sorry. Someone had to be sacrificed, and it was you. All right, guys, so that is gonna do us for tonight's live stream. Thanks for coming out and spending a couple hours with us as we harvested our oats here on the Western Wilds, as we harvested about half of our sorghum here. I'll have to finish this harvest up later. Tomorrow night, as I said, we will be on Forza Horizon 5 doing the weekly season playlist of events, trying to get all the awards, all the glory. Friday we may or may not be live streaming. It's going to depend on if I get my new stuff, and if I do get my new stuff, if I get it put in, and assuming it all works the way it should out of the box, right? So we'll have to see. Keep an eye on the channel. We'll post a live stream if we are indeed going to do something. And until next time, happy farming.